Podcast. I'm one of your hosts, Dr. Anton, and with me is the other host, DJ Spencer.
Hello.
Hello. It's a little late, so we're going to try to get through this as quickly as possible for us. This is episode 76, and we thought with some recent things that have happened in the community, we would take a little time out and do kind of a, I don't know if you want to call it like a clip show, but it's a kind of a tribute, let's say, to one of our friends out there, bigger partner and streamer, Wardog. He recently announced that he is retiring from streaming and from the bigger program. And so we just want to take this time to go back and look at all he's, you know, given us. He was a great streamer and just a fantastic partner, and just, you know, he was just, I think everyone loved him, so we just want to throw that back a little bit and celebrate him, you know.
Yeah,
this episode.
Yeah, he was a big supporter of the podcast and of us, and like he made a nice I guess comment about myself on the stream. And it actually kind of brought him to tears, and it kind of brought me to like a tear to my eye too. Just cause like I just made mention, and like I said it in the podcast episode that we had him as a guest, like he was literally the first Vigor streamer that I watched. And so when I made that comment, then, he made a nice comment about me type thing in turn, and
he was a class act.
I'm a little lost for words, and like I even like messaged him in, or put in his chat that his last stream, I was gonna say last episode, last stream, like that I was going to message him, and like I'm sorry I haven't actually done it yet. I honestly don't know what to say.
Yeah,
I don't know.
Yeah, it was definitely an emotional, emotional day for sure, right? So
it's like, it's funny because like for like us, it's like usually like we're not at a loss for words type thing, and like I don't know, even though we kind of planned this episode out like whatever, like 9 days ago or whatnot, whenever you suggested it, I'm like I still don't know what to say. Like I totally get it. You know, like he did mention on stream that, you know, for his mental and physical health, and you know, there's just a lot of things going on. He did get like promoted at work, so he's working like 12-hour days, and there's a bunch of other family things going on. He's got he's getting married next year to a Kiwi. There's just a lot. And he decided, you know what, he's done with streaming type thing. Like who knows, like maybe one day there he'll do like a one-off or something like that.
Right.
But like for most of us, like streaming is a hobby.
Exactly.
And it's like, because secondary, and like the amount of work he put in into streaming, into like the community type thing, like it takes its toll, like because there's only so many hours in the day and whatnot. So anyways,
yeah, and you know, exactly, he it is the thing when it's a hobby like this, there's quite a few of us, you know, it's just a hobby, and streaming Vigor, you know, we love Vigor, but it's not a huge category. So it's not, it's a hard one if you were, you know, if you decided I want to be a full-time streamer, Vigor would be a hard one to, you know, anchor that, right? Just because the numbers, the viewing numbers fluctuate wildly, especially when you know, various parts of the seasons, you know, that start, they start to taper off, but then there's events that'll bring them back. But, you know, it's when it's a hobby, it's one thing. When it's, if you're trying to make your life out of it, that's a whole different thing. So, and especially when you put a lot of work into it, like, and Wardog is one of those one, streamers who, even as a hobby, he put a lot of work into it. You could see, you could tell, like, he's always coming up with different things for his stream. He put out content on YouTube, and that's time consuming, because I tried, and I don't have the technical skills to do it half the time, and then it's also the time to put into it to try to build it, right? So
yeah,
and he did that, and he was just fantastic. So, and I should say is fantastic. He's not gone. He's just no longer streaming.
And he is still, like, he's not getting rid of, like, Twitch altogether. Like, he's still going to be around on Twitch. It's just he's not streaming anymore.
Yeah.
So, and he said he's going to jump in with Dizzy for the Fortnite Saturday squads, which Dizzy wasn't able to this yesterday because Fortnite was switching seasons type thing. It came to an end and whatnot. It's like the intermission. I don't know what you want to call it.
It's the in between, right? Because so, they do the whole event when a season ends, and then as they're bringing the new season in, there's a little bit of a gap. Yeah, for sure.
But he will be around. Changing.
Yeah, and you were mentioning how he was the first one you had ever watched. He wasn't the first I had ever watched, but it didn't take me long to find him. But I think when I started watching Wardog, it was right around the time that he was doing the giveaway. Like, he and Chappers were doing the Switch giveaway.
Crazy.
Yeah. Okay. I couldn't remember. I thought it was Chappers. That's the only name I could remember. So
it was Chappers crazy. Never streamed. So
Chappers. Oh, okay. I didn't realize that. But it's been a few years, so I don't know. I couldn't tell you if Crazy streams still or not. So
nope.
Okay, there you go.
He hasn't streamed in some time.
Gotcha. Okay. Anyways, but that I believe it was that giveaway that I started, that I found him. So, and then yeah, watched a ton. And I have to admit, like, I haven't been able to be in his streams as often as I used to, just because work has been gotten busier. Right. It was a time when I started watching him and others. It was during the pandemic. Right. So it was a lot of working from home. And even though you're working sometimes, there was a little bit more leeway at that time. It was easier to watch a stream and do work at the same time, as when you're in an office, very different vibe, right? It's harder, right?
Yep.
So it's a huge hit to the Vigor community. But we're here to celebrate Wardog, and we're going to, you know, talk about him and show various clips. We've pulled a bunch of stuff from his Twitch and a little bit from his YouTube that we're going to share as we talk about Wardog and, you know, just celebrate him. Before we get too far, though, please share, like, and subscribe. We appreciate it. Leave a comment below. Yep. Let us know. If you were a fan of Wardog's, when did you start watching? How did you discover Wardog? Let us know in the comments. We'd love to hear it. And I'm sure once he, you know, stops hating us for doing this and he reads the comments, he'd probably love to see your comments too.
I'm sure he'll be okay with it. He won't like copy strike us. We're gonna, but in any case, we will leave links to his channel and stuff, because like these are all Twitch clips, so they're not going away unless he deletes the channel, which he said he wasn't intending to. So they should be there. And I do recommend, like, the tough thing going through the clips is like there's been really great kills and everything like that, but it's like, honestly, he was not just like a great Vigor player, but like he was like an entertainer. And I hope that you know, people will see, like, in the clips, like, there, he was entertaining, he was funny, there's like kind of like tongue-in-cheek stuff, how much work he put into the stream, like it is just a wide variety. And it's like I said, he had some great kills and everything like that, but it's like, I just, the focus on that, I don't think, like, it's not, that's just not no. him. Like, nah, it's not, no. he is a great, you know, player, but, like, he has many sides, too. And I hope, like, the clips will kind of show that off type thing, so.
Absolutely, yeah. And he was, you know, he was one of those people who was, like, just very real with the community, right? Oh, give me one second here. I'm just having a bit of a hiccup with my Stream Deck here, just because it has to reconnect after I had an OBS crash. But anyways, he was one of those people who didn't just share fun times, but he also shared a lot of achievements, or, you know, stuff in his personal life, right?
Yeah.
That he shared that with the community, and he was good about that. He wanted everybody to partake in his, you know, his triumphs and his joys. So, and we really appreciate that. So we're going to show a couple of clips here, just of some special moments that happened on stream. This first one has to do with what's coming later. Was it next year? But let's just play it.
As we all know, it was Kiwi's birthday this weekend. She's turned the big 3-0. So in that moment, Wardog may have proposed to Kiwi. Hang on, Dizzy's not here. So the big announcement is myself and Kiwi are now going to be getting hitched. Well, married. Everyone's invited, by the way. All invited. This is an official official announcement. Congrats. Thank you very much, everyone. So that's my big announcement. That's my big announcement. Do you know, I totally forgot to turn off the redeems. As we all...
Which... It's funny because he kind of like, sorry, I don't have the audio of it, so I'm kind of like just going off the memory. And it's funny that in his last stream, I actually made a joke that, you know, he didn't have to stop streaming because he couldn't afford to like fly all of Twitch chat out.
to the wedding.
To the wedding, even though we kind of like got an invite there. But yeah, it's definitely a special moment. Kiwi, who they've been together for a number of years, you know, they got together with Dizzy and Tiny, and that's when he proposed Kiwi. And She said yes, for better or worse. We'll see. And it's funny, I remember that stream too. It's like, I remember I was like throwing up my baby emotes in the chat type thing just to like egg them on. Anyway.
And Kiwi's streamed with him. She was also a big participator in his stream. Not always on camera, but you know, quite often. She's always in the chat, almost always in the chat.
Yeah.
You know,
even though she's working.
Even though she's working or whatnot. If anyone she works with is watching, she wasn't doing it when she was working. But yeah. So it is great that they could share that announcement with everybody. And we really appreciate it, and all the joy to them and happiness, right? This next clip is from when he became a bigger partner.
I didn't realize the time, but anyway, here we go.
Burn it or burn it.
Turn it, burn it, chat. I have just received an email. I've just received an email from Vigor, and you guys are now looking at Vigor's newest partner. We done it, chat. We got partner, chat. We got partner. Oh my god.
It was awesome how excited he was.
I didn't realize.
There we go. Yeah, how excited he was to become a bigger partner. Yeah.
Yeah. And then for anyone who knows the story or does know the story, so he had the starting screen on, and Vigor of the Game, I believe it was Vigor of the Game. It's either that or one of the developers. I don't know if I should say the name or not, but anyways, they were in their chat and in his chat and basically said, Wardog, check your emails, check your emails. And then he, as like he's getting ready and this, like the stream's already started, like it's on the starting soon screen, he opens up an email, and then that's when he finds out that, you know, he's been accepted into the partnership. And then like on the podcast episode that we interviewed him, he said how like he was yelling down to Kiwi, who was in the kitchen getting like supper ready and everything, and like, what? And she's like, I'm making supper. And yeah, so he was just super thrilled. And then the whole thing became kind of like a meme type thing where it's like, hey, check your emails. You know, if he did something bad, they'd be like, hey, check your emails. Or, you know.
Yeah, it's always check your emails.
Yeah. And even when I got partnered too, even though I don't stream when, well, I stream like in ungodly hours when on their side of the planet. But anyways, when that's basically how I found out, was he actually sent me a Discord DM saying, hey, check your emails. So like the meme kind of like kept going. I remember that day so much because he wanted like everyone to be there, like, you know, G40 was like working or something like that, so he wasn't there, Dizzy wasn't there yet, it was funny. But it was so good. Like two and a half years ago, roughly, that happened. So
pretty close. And, yeah,
And yeah, so he got 6 months ago, roughly, he got the Easter egg for being a partner for over 2 years. And we'll see, like, the rules are that, you know, the Easter eggs are only for active partners. So because he gave up his partnership, you know, I guess technically they should remove it. But like, it, honestly, in my mind, it's like they should stay no matter what, just because, like, you know, these partners who qualify for these Easter eggs, like, they've contributed so much to the game that, you know, I would love to see even past present partners like included in the game as like kind of like a token of appreciation type thing
for all they've done.
So and like War Dogs has done so much, I would love to see it stick around, but I don't know, it's kind of out of our hands, I guess.
Well, it is, yeah. And they still, even with the backpacks or the bags, they're still like bags for partners that are no longer around, right? Like, they haven't gotten rid of those, have they?
Yeah.
Yeah. So it's the same kind of thing. Like, you know, it doesn't hurt anything to leave it in.
And you look at last anniversary, they put on like partner logos that, you know, same thing. They haven't played the game in ages type thing, and they left off Smokey Dopey, who is like, you know, the only campaign release partner that wasn't included, because Dizzy and Rex were included but not him, and then I forget which the other ones were, but so it's I don't know. I would love to see any Easter eggs from any partner, like, just stick around, unless like someone's been a total like done something illegal type thing, or like there's like serious allegations about it, like, okay,
I guess there's always going to be exceptions, but for the, you know, unless there's a, you know, reason not to, it'd be nice if they just kept it around for sure. And this last special announcement kind of one was from a fan gift that he received.
How cool is this, guys? But yesterday, I got told that I had a fan, a number one fan, a quite a big fan
who watches the stream a lot. This fan is, I think he's 7 years old. I think he's 7 years old. So yeah, slip ups are not so good. But he drew me a picture. Look at that. He drew me a picture of, he says that is a war dog right there. He said that is a war dog.
Yep.
How amazing is that? I had a number one fan, 7 years old, and he drew me a picture and he said, that's cool, isn't it? It's awesome. So yeah, he said, I really love watching your streams. And he said, that's a mutant. He's actually written up there. He's written mutant war dog, a mutant war dog. How cool is this guy?
Yeah, that's pretty cool. We've lost your camera.
OBS crashed on me, so I'm just coming in. But yeah, so that is from a, so Kiwi is a nanny, and that is one of the kids that she was taking care of at the time, because she would like kind of show off the stream, and that's a big reason why War Dog was effectively family friendly type thing. That's part of the decision why. Because he knew that there were, you know, potentially children watching. It was just kind of cool for him to get fan mail, and I'm pretty sure I'm the one who clipped that one, and because I was just like, man, this is like spectacular.
Yeah, that's pretty cool. Yeah, we can always appreciate it, and yeah, the family friendly thing, it's always, you know, a good idea, right? Like I don't have a lot of, I don't think I get a lot of, I've had a few though. I've had, like, younger people who've watched. I don't bill myself as family friendly, but then I also try to stay somewhat friendly anyways, right? Just because. So it's always nice when you can do those kind of things. Now let's see, do I have to do anything to get your video back into the thing here? Just double check. Oh yeah, because your link changed. Okay, give us 1 second, guys. just bear with us and be right back. Right. Okay. Give me 1 second here. Okay. We're back. And so, yeah, we got everything figured out. And I guess I'll have to rewatch this to make sure to see what actually happened. we're good. We're all here. But yeah, so that was War Dog's little fan moment. And so we're going to move into some more his more hilarious, funny clips that he's done. But first, before we get too far into the funny, I just wanted to talk about War Dog had a certain reputation when it came to Vigor. It has to do with taking a lot of damage from a certain way of playing. And so we're going to show a few clips from that, but he had a nickname. Was it like IX fall damage?
Yeah, there's a lot of them, but yeah, that's one of them. King of fall damage.
Definitely one of them. King of fall damage. Yeah.
And to the point where, like, he even kind of, I guess, made fun of himself, with his Easter egg, right? Because he had like the little warning sign, with his logo on it type thing. So he was like a good sport with it, and like kind of went with it, I guess. I don't know.
Yeah, yeah. But yeah, here's a few clips of Wardog and his fall damage and how, and you can really see with these clips how it, you know, it kept going over time, because the first you can sort of see how his setup changes throughout the different clips. So it's been happening for most of his bigger career.
Ah, there he is. Oh my god. Oh my god, are you serious, bro?
Yeah.
And see, that one is...
Wow!
That one, if I'm not mistaken, they were, like, coming back from a trip to Malta, I think, and they had to, like...
Oh my god!
...or something like that, because of...
Oh, gotcha. Okay.
But he had so brought that was like... or whatnot, or borrowed one.
Yeah, yeah.
But yes, no damage.
Fall damage, IX fall damage. And this is one where he was on Victorson, it looks like. But then you can see this is when he had a green screen, so he wasn't doing the chat, the window as much.
Oh my god! Oh my god!
Oh my god!
Oh my god!
The awareness of the surroundings.
She just done that.
Oh my god!
Legendary.
Did I actually just do that?
For sure.
I did not even see that. I literally ran. I just ran up right off the edge.
All right. Let's go to the next one here.
I'm going to have to drop this gun as well.
Good old... this is like sweater early on, but like he didn't have much on him, but... Yeah, this is doing the mountain jump.
No! What is going on, chat? No! No!
And he was just so dead that he had no...
How? Oh my god.
He couldn't do it. Yeah.
But yeah, I don't think he intended to like jump off that last one. But yeah. What I loved about that one is like the absolute confidence of like going up there and being like, oh, I just need to leave my gun, and then blah, 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 and then he falls, and it's like it was so funny. It's like I've been playing this game for I don't know 3 years, 4 years now, and it's like I still hate that jump. Like I can't make it.
It's terrible. Now that they have the adrenaline in the game, it does help. Like if you have it, like because then no matter what you're carrying, you can have a good chance of making that jump. You can still totally mess it up if you get your angle wrong, but
yeah.
And his last fall damage clip here.
Yeah, I will point out though that he has been he's made that jump 100.
Oh no!
Oh yeah.
Fall damage.
And yeah, this time it's Underberg, and he's playing with Chewie.
Oh my god!
Because I don't have the angle. But,
god!
I think it was Dizzy. I think it was Dizzy.
Takes a giant.
Yeah.
Off the ledge shape thing,
and then this where he has like happen? The IX fall damage emote.
Okay. Yeah,
he's showing up at the end there.
Yeah, and yeah, that's
oh,
one
no!
thing that right he lived up to it. He actually made it into an emote too. So he actually had a couple of variations because he had like the warning side and like the one where it's the person falling type thing. So
for sure. So and he was always great for just having a lot of funny moments. So we're just going to show, you know, some more funny clips as we go, and you know, just keep it going here. First one, it has Kiwi.
Yo, what is up, everyone?
And welcome into today's stream. How you all doing today? Welcome in.
Getting
yes.
A Kiwi hello into
that was a
stream.
Kiwi. That is a Kiwi. She is home. She's home. She's chilling in the background today. Woo-hoo. She's going to be...
So you got Kiwi to do it. Which is great.
Yeah, for sure. This next one has to do a little start he did with Captain Wardog.
Good afternoon, this is your captain speaking. Just a little flight information. We will be flying at an altitude of around 37,000 feet. Our airspeed will be about 400 miles an hour. The time is currently 3 p.m. Weather's looking good, and we are on schedule to land at 6 p.m. We have a great in-flight movie today. It is Wardog's Tour of the Outlets. Our onboard attendants today are TT96 and Kiwi Girl, should you need any assistance. But before we take off, please listen to our safety briefing.
In the event of sudden cabin pressure loss, masts will drop from the ceiling. Please put on your own mast before helping children. Should we need to make an emergency landing in the Outlands, all Xbox Game Pass users will receive a free Vigor perk. This includes weapons, a Vigor jacket, and crowns.
But for now, sit back, relax, and enjoy the in-flight movie.
Yeah, nice. And you can see, like, this is before he got partnered, and, like, how much time he put in.
How much work,
like,
he did on it, yeah.
Like, let's admit it, like, the bigger category when it comes to streaming is, like, you don't have a lot of people who actually put a lot of effort in it. Like, it is rare. There's maybe, like, you know, 5-10 people, maybe at best. You know, and it's not to knock anyone else down, but, like, the amount of work that he puts in, and, like, the other streamers that, you know, use OBS, the camera, transitions and scenes and stuff like that, it's, like, it's time-consuming, like we were talking about. And the amount of time it took him to do this, I'm sure, was, like, probably, like, 8 hours or something like that. Like, he mentioned it before, like, in the interview that we had with him, like, a year and a half ago, that, like, you know, he released a YouTube video, and it took him probably, like, 8 to 10 hours just to do that one video. And it's, like, you know, a 10-minute, 15-minute video, right? So, like, the amount of effort that went into this, like, it was huge, especially early on. Like, he admitted it too, like, he had to learn it all. So
it was
just a great intro that, you know, he ended up doing.
Sorry, I just fighting with a kitty here, but yeah. For sure. He did a lot of great, he had a lot of ideas, and he always tried to implement them and did his best. And yeah, he was really good, and he did some really good job. This next one is called
Go to the Gym. Fresh. It's number one. Number two, food changes, chat. I have signed up to HelloFresh. For those of you who don't know what HelloFresh is, it is a food box company. They send you food 5 days, like a big box up for 5 days worth of food. I've signed up for that because I need to make some food changes in my life. Pizzas, kebabs, tacos, everything that doesn't have vegetables in it and stuff like that. Going to the gym is number one. Number two, food changes, chat. I have signed up to HelloFresh. For those
of- I clipped this. So this was like, he was just doing an announcement about, like, he had to change his diet and everything like that. And I was like, hey, let's clip this. Let's make it, send it to HelloFresh, maybe, like, get him a sponsorship or something like that. I thought it was, like, great the way he kind of, like, brought it up. I'm like, you know, great spokesperson for HelloFresh. Definitely got me to sign up.
I had signed up for HelloFresh too, but it wasn't related to that. I don't believe, anyways. When I had it for a little while. But it was kind of funny. But the whole no tacos thing, Taco Tuesday was a huge thing. Yeah. So that was a big change.
They even had the redeem to Taco Tuesdays with the song.
Yeah, for sure. This next one is oh my god.
I have no idea where they've gone. They're in this vicinity somewhere.
He's just guessing where he's going to order.
Flipping it! Oh my god, this guy just stood behind me! Let's go! Oh my god! Paid actor? There's no way! They just stood behind me!
Hello there!
Some random person.
This random.
Oh my god! Like, what was this person doing?
Crazy funny moments like that.
You don't want to walk away, mate. You're gonna die.
You know, like, he's been hit with stream snipers.
I have no idea where they've gone.
I remember, like, his early days, there was always, like, someone near the top of the leaderboards that always seemed to, like, be in his games and always seemed to know where he was, type thing. But yeah, it's always, like, funny, weird stuff like that would seemed to happen to him. But yeah.
Yeah, it does, like, stream sniping is a thing, and it happens to all of us on occasion. Like, I've even had it. But I think it happened to them a little more often just because of their stream times. Like, because for us, their stream times would always be in the middle of the day, right, in North America. And so I think if you're going to get stream snipers, I don't know if it's true or not. Maybe I'm just, but it really seems to be a North American thing. Sort of a toxic, I don't know, thing that happens here more. I don't know if you get too many European stream snipers, but I don't know, maybe.
Maybe. I think it's a worldwide thing. I don't think it's just a North American thing.
Maybe, but you never know. next little funny clip.
Watch this. Yeah, so this is him and Dizzy.
Oh my god, that is so sick.
The problem they used to have with what? Yeah, the major big problem they had was sliding rocks. Yeah.
Yeah, it was definitely funny.
Don't work that way.
Yeah.
it just showed, like, you know, he wasn't always out to just get killed.
Love that.
It's not about just, like, going out, getting threat. You know, it's about having fun, playing video games.
Yeah, for sure. Move on to this next one quickly. Nade.
But, like, in those bushes. Oh shit! Oh my god! What a
nade! Yeah.
And it's like, and this is like, you know, it's a great clip because, you know, like, you post that on like YouTube, TikTok, or whatever. It's like, you could use that because it's like, you could use it as a promotion thing, right? Because it's like a hype clip, essentially. And it is like, it's genuine excitement on his part that, you know, grenade kills aren't that easy to come by. And so it's like, you know, when he gets that excited, it's like, you know, he's genuinely excited.
Yeah, no, for sure. And this is before they made the big changes to the grenades. And now, well, grenades are very different now. You can still get good kills with them for sure. But this is, I think, fairly, you know, earlier on with the grenades. And yeah, when you got a kill like that, you just have to celebrate. It was just a big thing.
And I would like to point out too, he also said the S word.
He did. I was like, ooh.
Which is, I guess, I don't know, depending where you're from, it's not family friendly, but.
Yeah, you know, yeah. But it's one of those things that everyone slips up, right? It's like, you could be.
Honestly, it's not that bad. Everyone poops. Yeah. That's my argument.
Exactly. And there was a fantastic Canadian TV show called Schitt's Creek, so check it out. then you're safe saying it, for sure. You can even say it on talk shows, as long as you're referring to that show.
Yes.
Yeah. Okay, next we have
we've reverted back to an old cut. It's not a very good one, mind you. It's the, you know, cheap, tacky, not worth even get in, to be fair. You know, it's one of these, you can't really see it because it's green, but for those of you who know what it is, yeah, mm-hmm, just mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying.
There used to be a big thing though. You were like, what cup was today? But you know,
I joked, and then that just happened
to be Dizzy's cup, and it's with the green screen. It just shined right through.
So we
he's kind of like giving Dizzy a hard time with like the poor merch or whatever, but it was good. The banter was always top notch, and yeah, he even had like the, now that you mentioned it, yeah, he did have the cup cam at one point where it was a cam that literally just showed off his cup. That's right, I totally forgot.
If someone wanted to see his cup, you'd turn on the cup cam. But speaking of Dizzy, this next clip has to do with Dizzy.
Where do you think they are?
I see you.
Oh, they're in the toilet. Yeah,
like a scared little outlander stuck in a room.
Chat, I'm trying to.
Hey! Hey!
He's coming.
Oh! Killed him. Everyone just like, ah!
It made me laugh so much when, like, because he. he's actually like tried to make friends with like, you know, green coats and stuff like that. And it's like to have Dizzy, who also makes friends with green coats on occasion, like literally just walks in and just shoots him in the head one tap. So it was like, because you don't see Dizzy easy, right? He's like behind him.
And they're both kind of funny, right? Because they're both, you know, the type, they're both streamers that are very friendly. And even in the Outlands, you know, if they run across somebody and they try, sometimes they'll try to make friends with them. And so you see something like that, which is almost like opposite of how they normally would do it. So it's like they like to troll each other once in a while. So is you know, it's all good fun, and it's pretty funny, especially that clip. This is a raid suggestion.
Wardog, I don't usually ask, but can I suggest a raid? Raid the refrigerator. There's a lot of delicious food and drink. Flipping out the... Whoa! Wardog, I don't usually ask, but...
This one, I'm not so... I don't know this one. Santa. Oh, yeah. Go ahead.
Well, you could play the Santa one, too.
Okay.
Wardog, why is Santa so good at karate? I don't know. I don't know, DJ Spencer. If it's bad, I'm ending stream. Because he has a black belt.
So I'll admit those last two clips, I at one point I would actually pose dad jokes in his stream and kind of like trolly, because he, I don't know, he says he doesn't like dad jokes, but I don't believe him. And yeah, so I thought it was spectacular, and every time I would do it, I would actually clip it. And that last one ends, but he actually did hit the end stream button after it, but he came back as a joke type thing. So it was hilarious.
It's awesome. Yeah, and there's a lot of chat trolled, you know, and that's just part of it. It was always in good fun, and this next clip is an example of that.
Bruh! Guys, Vigor Founders Pack, if you want to get involved. Well, I'm turning that thing off. Say it up. Right, where is it? Bruh, redeem it now. Redeem it now. I don't matter about the Scooby Dooby Doo. Right. That's how you want to play it.
Watch me do my dad.
That's how you boy and girls want to play it.
Watch me do my dad, like I'm taking a nap.
Bruh, do something now. Do something now.
Just get
Do something now.
Not really upset.
Yeah, highlight your message. Message, chat.
We were like spamming like all the
things. Bruh.
Tried to like run a giveaway for like a Vigor Founders Pack or whatever. We just kept interrupting, and it was so good.
Yeah, it's awesome. And he always took it in stride. You know, you might think, oh, is he getting upset? He's not getting upset. He's just, it's just the, you know, mock upset, you know. It's like, yeah, okay, guys, I get it. Yeah, but he was always fun that way, for sure. He also, like, he would post a few, he was really good with taking like clips, and he didn't have a huge number of them up on YouTube, but he would throw some up there with some editing and that. And so it was always he came up with some pretty entertaining clips. I'm going to show a couple of those right now. The first one, it's like where it has to do with a flash grenade, and but then he mixes it with a really popular British comedian, and of course I can't remember the comedian's name at the moment.
Lee Evans,
thank you. Yes, for sure. So we'll just throw that one up here.
Oh, fuck. Oh, it's a lie. Oh, it's coming this way. I love lies.
I can't see.
I'm blind. Oh, I just killed him.
And he still manages to get a couple kills.
Oh, fuck. Oh, it's a lie. Oh, it's coming this way.
Did it finish already? I guess it was shorter than I thought it was. Okay. And then there was also one here where he just gets a really good grenade kill that got him some fan mail.
They're above me, chat. I can hear them. Oh, flipping heck, I killed him! Jesus!
Yep. Emotional damage.
Damage. Yeah.
Stephen He, awesome comedian, YouTuber.
Yeah, for sure.
Yeah.
Yeah. Now we have a bunch of outtakes. These are all clips from his channel as well. Yep. So I don't know if I've really seen many of these, so we'll see how that goes. I'm not sure what an outtake is.
Guess what we got, guys? We got the big D cup.
Yeah, it's a bunch of like tongue-in-cheek stuff, just like miscellaneous clips, really.
Yeah, I'll just go through them fairly quickly.
I cannot hold any grudges, cannot be salty about that at all. He literally turned around and pumped me in the face. That sounded dodgy, but let's go.
Not PG. I thought usually guys give the sword. Oh my god, Atomic! Oh my
goodness.
I should have.
That's Iron Horsey, that one.
Yeah.
Name Atomic.
Oh, it's. Atomic.
Atomic, look what Iron Horsey said.
It's normally Atomic that puts it in. It's normally Atomic that's the non PG one.
Poor bloke. I'm apologising.
I just out an Atomic shocker for no reason. It was actually Iron Horsey. Imagine.
Yeah, baby. Love the big D. Yeah, baby. Love the big D.
Love the big D.
Yeah. We get surprised.
Oh wait! Ah, sugar! Oh my God! Jeez Louise! Holy God!
The stress of having streaming.
Yeah.
Oh, I was about to say that milkshake brings all the boys to the yard, and they're like, "It's better than yours."
Is that name? Did you get that name because you came in and saw this face? But welcome in. How you doing, Mr. Double Dongs? Chat. Welcome into the. Or it could be Miss Double Dongs. You never know.
Could be.
Welcome in. Thank you very much. G40's
out. G40's out. Snapchat filter.
Welcome in. Thank you very much for the follow. How are we?
Yeah. Set up.
I'm going to screen.
Yeah, like someone with like. Provocative name.
It's funny when he did that. Yeah. Yep. Yeah. So there's some quick outtakes from his stream. And yeah, I get how those are outtakes now. Oh, you want to go now, Kitty? Okay. But yeah, he was always joking around. He's always really good at that. That's something I know I'm not great at, the banter, right? It's he was always great with the banter. And you could learn, just watching his videos and that, you could learn a lot from him. He has a natural way. I didn't want to say like it's past tense. We know he's going to be around on occasion. So just not streaming as like he used to. But yeah, he has a natural way just of narrating and interacting with everybody. And it's just fantastic. Yeah.
Yeah.
For sure. There was also, I have a couple of little bit longer clips here. These are just from YouTube that I just thought were pretty good. There's a one here called Karma that I just wanted to throw up.
Hey, I'm a potato. That's really all I got.
Yeah, I love the fact that he did this too with like a clip.
Come here!
You know, like he came up with an idea.
Where are you going?
Like, a little shorter video. At one point, like, he fast forwards it.
Yeah, and playing the Benny Hill music over top. Yeah. And there was something there, like during this clip, someone plays the gearbox. And that was a great running.
Get
dead. Kills him at the end, you know, just the guys like hiding near an exit.
We've got the redeem going on.
Few moments later.
Yeah, and then leaves the cave, and then.
Oh shit! That's karma for you, chat. That is karma.
Yeah, that's fantastic. Yeah. but yeah, he's always really good at just taking those little moments that happen and in a game and then making something with it. So it's really good. And speaking of another one, here's another quick one that, not quite as long as that, but it's just, a good grenade one where he gets surprised by somebody. And it's just one of those things where you never know where a grenade's going to bounce, but it just happens to be perfect.
Yeah. And I could be wrong, but this might have been his first grenade kill, too.
Oh. Okay.
I think when after the grenades came out.
Maybe.
So,
yeah.
Like I said, I could be wrong, but I think this might be the first one.
Yeah.
Forever immortalized, if that is the case.
For sure. And then he also got pretty creative too. Like when like Vigor would have like special events or contests, you know, he would try to throw something in into them as well. And so there was a an event they had where they were getting people to do little stories with emotes, right? And so he threw together a little one here that I'm going to play, and it's all available on his YouTube as well. So we'll check this out. Good choice of music to throw in there.
And it's great because he actually kind of makes fun of himself.
The dam and yeah.
So it's like kind of mocking
his fall damage, yeah. And then he does another one with the jump off the pass.
Great job.
He did a really good job, yeah, just tying that all together. I can't imagine how long it took him to put that all together too, so I'm sure it took a while. Yeah. But yeah, we're almost done. We just have a couple more things we're going to show. DJ had the pleasure of playing a few times with Wardog. I never got the opportunity myself, but you were able to get on there a few times and stream with him.
Yeah. And so I may have taken some mornings off without my wife knowing, mm-hmm. so I could jump on. A few times I was able to join him on stream and, you know, have some games with him, which was fun. It was hairy though, yeah, at times, because like I remember there's like, again, you know, stream snipers or like full on sweaty lobbies. You know, so some of the lag on my end because, you know, he's playing in the EU. And, so
Yeah, he's in the EU. We're in North America, so there. Sometimes when you jump into those games, that it can make a big, it can make a big difference with lag and stuff for sure. But yeah, here, here's the first one where you're actually playing with Kiwi as well.
I'm gonna go kill DJ Chat.
Hurry up!
Kiwi, hug that red Right.
So I literally just killed War Dog.
Lay down.
Okay, I didn't realize that was part of this. Okay. Okay.
Spence is behind you.
Playing with Key and.
Like how you fell too. Like perfectly flat.
No. It was not Kiwi. You literally can hear Kiwi tell Ward.
Oh.
He's behind you. So basically, he
took over, the controller.
Hurry up.
Oh, I didn't realize that. That's awesome.
Oh, yeah. And he literally says, like, I'm going to go kill DJ.
I did hear that, but I didn't put it together that's what happened. Yeah. That's awesome.
So you literally left and went to jump on the controller with for Kiwi and then killed
that's
me.
That's hilarious.
My intention was like I killed War Dog. I was going Kiwi was the last one left because I think I killed TT. I killed the War Dog and then I was going to like let Kiwi live and then that wasn't going to happen.
And we have another clip here where he's spectating. Oh no, was he spectating? Yeah. Who's he spectating?
Let's see. Spectating me. So gotcha. Basically, we were running duos, and like we ran into like a sweaty
nice.
Duo. And basically, I got the drop, and it's we'll like, see I had no more heals.
They're coming, DJ.
For the mill exit in Belcanton.
He's above you. I might just watch this.
Like the dresser.
He's in
by the exit. And I mistakenly said contact bombs, but it is booby trap.
They're gonna loot him, mate.
You see, like the team.
He's gonna know. Come on, there's the cabinet. There it is.
So, anyways, I'm like, hey, I booby trapped like the tall dresser.
He's doing it. He's on it.
He took damage.
Oh, he did, DJ! You killed him! DJ, you got him!
Explosion, but then did it just not show the explosion because we're looking through the eyes of
Yeah.
Okay.
So you didn't see the explosion because of it. Because like he had like a quarter of health left.
Yeah.
So
right.
Yeah, that was my first trap kill. But nice. Yeah, like I was like, War Dog was like kind enough to like spectate the other people and see what would happen type thing. So it was kind of cool to see that happen on his stream.
Yeah. So there you go. That was fantastic. Yeah. So some clips to show our love for War Dog there. We really appreciate all he's given to the community and just all of us. He's just a great guy. Yeah. He's pouring it out. I've got mine ready to go.
Oh,
give
I
him
actually
a Canadian
have
salute. Oh wow, look at that.
Yeah. But so, yeah, cheers to
cheers,
War Dog.
We salute you.
Yep. maybe you should have done that at the start. I don't know how I'm going to go to bed after this, but.
It shouldn't be that much sugar. It shouldn't keep you that much longer.
I don't know. But I've been drinking A&W root beer too.
Oh, it'll be fine.
It's so sweet.
It is. Yeah, there you go.
But yeah, War Dog, I don't know what to say again. It's like, hard to imagine not being able to see you Tuesdays and Thursdays streaming and, you've
Words
been a big
stream.
Supporter. Yeah, Words on Stream. You've been a big supporter of myself, the podcast.
He came on when you became partner. Was it right?
No, Dizzy filled in.
Oh, is Dizzy? Sorry, my mistake.
But War Dog. We've had him a number of times. I want to say three times on the podcast. Two or three.
Yeah.
and it's like, I don't know, you've done so much for like the Vigor community, myself, the game. I don't know. I don't know. I honestly don't know what to say. Like,
we don't know what to say. We'll miss you, but we're glad you're still going to be around in the community and doing stuff with Dizzy. So we'll definitely catch you on those streams whenever we can. And you know, don't forget us. Reach out, say hey every once in a while, and we'll do the same.
Oh, another thing too, like he would get up so early for work, where it's like 2:30 and he's on his way to work, and he'd actually like pop into the stream. Like it's he'd be like, sorry, I can't chat, but like he's like, I'm on my drive home, my drive to work type thing. And it's like he literally just catch the end of the stream type thing because of how late I stream and how early he wakes up type thing.
So it's always great when he did stuff like that, for sure.
I don't know. I don't know. I can't put my words into. I don't know. I'm trying not to be emotional, but it's tough. It's not like we're losing him. He's still going to be around and everything, but I don't know. And it's like, you know, he could have chosen to, you know, just keep the partnership type thing and just like sit back and see what the
future scale back or whatever. But
because you know, like, you know, partners can't take breaks. And it's like I'm a big supporter of that, especially like. But knowing how what I'm going through right now is like is just like I'm not getting sleep. It's like the two kids and everything, like it's tough to stream and everything and create content and, you know, make content that is like up to par or whatever. It's not just going through the motions type thing. And like he could have waited and seen if things changed and like then pick it back up type thing and whatnot, but he decided to like, you know, step back and everything. And I respect him for that. I would have supported his decision either way.
We appreciate it. And
I support all partners, like legacies, you know, active ones. It's all the same. Real life comes first. And I'm glad that War Dog is putting real life first.
Absolutely.
You know, we'll miss seeing him on the screen, but I know he's still there.
For sure. And so, I think this is going to be a great time for us to stop, but we love you, and we hope to see you out there, and hearts hurt. But and who knows, maybe in the future, maybe we can even get you back on the podcast. Who knows? But until next time, I'm Dr. Anton.
And I'm DJ Spencer.
Stay safe in the Outlands and have a great night.
Night.
Bye.
Bye.
love you.